Hello, welcome to my talk on why we need to carry out dimensional analysis, part 1, the design optimizations in fluid dynamics. Generally, for most fluid dynamic problems, they are more than just solve the fluid dynamic equations. Although it indeed gives us the very important parameters, the fluid field. However, in many practical problems, we wish to understand the fluid structure interactions. That is, under the given conditions, what is the fluid force acting on the structure? And to seek an optimized solution to our design, we need to look at how the forces would be influenced by the different environment parameters. If we examine the individual environment parameters in a direct manner, we would have numerous scenarios to look at. Then we might have the difficulties. Can we solve the Navier-Stokes equation or carry out the experiment studies on all these scenarios? We will see what the real problems for the fluid dynamics. In this talk, I will make a short introduction on the basic solutions method in fluid dynamics. And then I will introduce the intermediate physical parameters in theoretical and experimental fluid dynamics. And then I will show how we can calculate the force moment acting on the body. We will see how the force depends on the environment parameters and see the difficulties in the direct method for optimization purpose. In fluid dynamics, generally we have two different approaches. They are theoretical approach and the experimental approach. In the theoretical approach, we may need to solve Navier-Stokes equation for fluid dynamics, such as CFD. Or we might solve the Euler equation, solve the fluid problem for inviscid flows. Or we might solve the potential flow problem if we can assume the flows are potential. All these three approaches can be taken as numerical approaches since we solve the fluid dynamics problems using computers. And then we might have semi-empiric method. This can be solved for some specific simple flow problem. And the analytic solutions, for instance, the very simple laminar flows. For experimental approach, we might have field test. This is for large or full-scaled devices, including flight test or sea chires. Wind tunnel and tank test. These are for the scaled model test under the well-controlled test conditions and the environment. We may also have simple test on test rigs. This can be useful for some fundamental test or the component test. In theoretical flow dynamics, generally, we need to solve the Navier-Stokes equation. The Navier-Stokes equation includes the moment equation given as this, three moment equations for three velocity components, u, v, and w. And we also have the continuity equation given as this. This is for incompressible flows. To solve Navier-Stokes equation, under the given initial and the boundary conditions, these equations would form perfect equations. We have four equations, three momentum equations, and one continuity equation. Solving for four unknowns, the fluid field parameters, the pressure, and the velocity component, U, V, and W. This is a perfect dynamic system. Here, we are not talking about how we can solve the Navier-Stokes equation. And we assume we can reliably obtain all the field parameters, pressure, velocity component, from solving Navier-Stokes equation. In experimental fluid dynamics, similarly, under the given initial and boundary conditions, we can measure the pressure and the pressure distributions, use the pressure transducers and the pressure taps. And we also measure the fluid velocities, use different methods. For instance, PIV, the particle energy velocimetry, LDV, laser Doppler velocimetry, hot wire anemometer, pitcher tubes, venturi tubes, propeller flowmeter, etc. It should be noted here, these fluid parameters are all point properties. Thus, we need to measure them in many points. In fact, the more the measurement, the better would be. And in some experiments for fluid dynamics, forces and the moment acting on the body would be measured, if this can be done. Generally, this can be easily done to measure the force, since we only measure a single value for a force component. And this measurement would be redundant with the field measurement, and thus can be used for cross-checking the measurement. Now we might have a question. What are these field parameters used for? In fact, these parameters are very important and generally can be used for following purpose. The direct utilization is for understanding the fluid field. For instance, to see whether the flow would be smooth or whether there will be a fluid separation. And as the intermediate parameters, which can be used for calculating the force acting on the body. In reality, for fluid dynamic problems, we wish to predict the forces on the body, since the fluid forces are the primary quantities in most design. See the reference for the external flow problem. It should be noted that the fluid force acting on the body can be only calculated from these intermediate fluid field parameters, the pressure P and the velocity vector V. We will see this in the next two slides. For the fluid dynamic problem, the force and the moment can be obtained if the pressure and the shear stress on the body surface are known. The force vector would be calculated given as this, and the moment acting on the body would be given as this. Here, the moment would be referred to the origin of this coordinate. So, to get the force and the moment, we need the fluid pressure P on the body surface, see this, as well as the shear stress tau on the body surface. So we can see here the pressure is perpendicular to the body surface, while the shear stress is tangent to the body surface. So from the previous slide, if we solve the fluid dynamic problem by solving the Navier-Stokes equation or by measuring the fluid pressure, the pressure is known, and the shear stress on the body, we need to find a way for calculating this. We will talk this in the next slide. And for the normal vector, vector n, and the tangent vector on the surface can be obtained if the structure is given. Suppose we already solve the fluid field, for instance, the velocity distribution near the body surface, see here, or if we measure the velocity distribution, then we can calculate the shear stress tau given by this. If the velocity distribution is measured, and then the partial differentiation of the velocity with regard to y can be calculated, and this would be calculated at y equaling to zero. Therefore, if we solve the fluid dynamic equation, or if we measure the fluid field parameters, the pressure, the velocity, then we can calculate the force acting on the body. Now in this slide, we will see how we can design airfoil, which ideally has a high lift and a low drag. Principally, we would set up a flow passing airfoil and solve it in either numerical modeling or experiment study. See the plot here. For this problem, our purpose is to understand the dependencies of the force on the following environment parameters: the incoming flow velocity V0, the size of the airfoil, here C, the chord of the airfoil. And we also look at the fluid viscosity, which would vary dependent on the temperature, if the airfoil would be used in the different altitude, as well as the fluid density. This would be dependent on the altitude, since the fluid density would change dramatically in different altitude in the space. And we may also look at the surface roughness. Here we should be noted the field parameters, pressure P and the velocity component, are the intermediate variables. So they are used for calculating the force rather than as the parameters of the force depending on. Following the reference, the force acting on the airfoil would be depending on many parameters. The incoming flow velocity V0, this is for sure. The higher the incoming fluid velocity, the force would be larger. The size of the body, the chord length C, or the general size as capital D. So it is understandable, for large size of the airfoil, we would have a large lift. The force would be also depend on the fluid viscosity and the density, the surface roughness, and probably depending on the speed of the sound if the airfoil used in high speed flows such as the transonic or supersonic or hypersonic flows, and etc. As such, the force acting on the airfoil can be expressed as a function of all these parameters: the incoming flow, the size of the structure, the viscosity of the fluid, the fluid density, the roughness of the structure surface, the speed of the sound, etc. Now we are asked the question, how we can find out the dependence of the force on these parameters, this function. Generally, this is a very difficult question. For a different project or design, the dependence would be very different. Hence, for a design, we need to find the dependence. Therefore, we need to change all the parameters individually and to see how the force would change accordingly. Generally, if we need to find the dependence of the force on the specific parameter, we need to examine at least three different values for the specific parameter. And the three values should cover the value we are interested in. Three different values would be the least for the purpose of a good interpolation. For instance, we can use three or more different incoming flow velocity to study the effect of the incoming velocities on the force. And this should be same for other parameters. If we have many parameters, as seen in this expression, then the combination of the changes for all the parameters would be very large. It should be larger than 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, etc., depends on how many parameters we have. Here, 4 threes means for 4 parameters. Now we can see the difficulties in the direct approach. We know solving Navier-Stokes equation is very time-consuming, and if we want to solve Navier-Stokes equation for so many combinations, it would be very time-consuming, and it would be prohibited. It would also be very difficult and costly in experiment study for such combinations. For instance, changing the model for changing the size of the model. If we need to change three sizes of the model, that means we need three different models. Changing the fluid for changing the fluid density and the viscosity would be very difficult and costly if it is not impossible. And then if we have somehow collect all the required data from the numerical modeling or from the experiment studies, then we would have yet another question, how we can present the data or build a relation between the force and the multi-parameters. I will talk this on the second part on this topic.